Hi guys, welcome back to SS Gaming Unity 3D. In today's video, we're going to learn how to implement Firebase Remote Config in our Unity project, so let's get started. But first, what exactly is Remote Config and why should you use it? Firebase Remote Config is a super powerful tool that allows you to change your game's behavior and content in real time without having to update your app on the Play Store. Here's how it works behind the scenes. You define certain values on the Firebase server, and your game will fetch those values when it starts. Based on what you receive, you can control how your game behaves. For example, imagine you have a float variable on Firebase representing your app's latest version. After fetching this value, you can compare it with the version stored inside your game. If the player's version is older, you can prompt them to update the app. And that's just scratching the surface. From changing UI text to enabling new features, the possibilities with Remote Config are endless.
So now, let's dive into the Unity setup and see how to bring this into action.
Alright, so first, we'll start by creating a new Unity project using Unity 6. Open up your Unity Hub, click on New Project, give your project a name and choose a location to save it. Then, click Create. Once Unity finished setting up the project, we'll move on to integrating Firebase step by step, starting with downloading the SDK and setting up the Firebase console. So now that our Unity project is created, let's set it up for Android. Now go to Player and set your company name and product name. After setting this, now go to Other setting and set the minimum API level to Android 6.0 API level 23 and the target API level to the highest installed version. And copy the package name. We'll use this later when setting up the Firebase project. Now that all the Unity settings are done, it's time to move over to Firebase and create our Firebase project. This is where we'll manage our remote config settings and connect them to our Unity app. So, let's head to the Firebase console and set things up step by step. Now go to the official Firebase website and create a new project. If you're not sure how to do this, don't worry. I've already explained the full process in detail in my Google login setup video. So if you face any issues here, make sure to check out that video for a step-by-step guide. Now that the Firebase app setup is complete, let's move to the Remote Config section. In the left sidebar of the Firebase console, scroll down and click on Remote Config, then click on Create Configuration to create your first variable. This is where we'll define the values that our Unity app will fetch and use at runtime. Now set the name to app version or whatever you want, and give it a value like 1.0, then click Publish Changes. Now go back to Unity and import the Firebase Remote Config SDK into your project. Now let's remove the errors by following me step by step. Now go to External Dependency Manager and click on Resolve and then click on Force Resolve to resolve dependencies. Now go and download the Google Services.json file from the Firebase console and import it into your Unity project. Make sure the streaming assets folder is created successfully and the file is placed inside it. Now everything is set up, it's time to create an empty game object, attach a new script to it, and rename the script to Remote Config. And then open the script to any of your code editor. Now go to the Firebase Remote Config documentation, copy the sample code, and paste it into your script just like I'm doing. Then we'll fix the errors by adding the missing libraries step by step. Now our main function is running. I'm going to edit the script to get values from Firebase. Just follow my code step by step. I will also provide the script. The download link will be in the description. If you have any issues, feel free to comment below in the comment section. Now you can see we've successfully printed the values from Firebase, and it's working perfectly. You can now use this value to control anything in your game like updates, assets, features, or whatever you want. Now it's working perfectly. Next, I'm going to update the script and create a class to store values like name, version, level, and more. Now, to print the JSON format of this class, write the code at the start to convert and print it as JSON. Then we'll copy this JSON and add it as a new parameter in Firebase, so all these values will be stored in one JSON object. If the JSON is showing as null, don't worry. We just need to mark our class as serializable to fix this. Now copy the JSON data, go to your Firebase project, delete the old parameter, and create a new one. Set the parameter name, and in the value section, paste your JSON data, then click Publish Changes. Now that we've updated the code, JSON file, and Firebase parameter, go ahead and play the game. You'll see the values showing correctly in the inspector. You can now do anything with this class, extended as needed based on your game's requirements. As a quick example, I've added a simple text update to show you how version control works, so watch carefully and follow along. Now you can see that everything is working perfectly, and I hope you fully understood how Firebase Remote Config works in Unity. If you face any issues or have questions, just drop a comment below, I'll definitely reply and help you out. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more Unity and Firebase tutorials. This is SS Gaming Unity 3D, I'll see you in the next one. Happy coding!